Right, so I'm very grateful to be joined right now by Dale Ladouceur, whom I first saw performing in Edmonton's LRT back probably around 1992, something like that, in remarkable acoustics. And your amazing presence stayed with me all those years, and I met you years after that. And you're still playing this phenomenal instrument. It's the Chapman Stick. Why is it called that?
Emmett Chapman invented it about 1971, so truly it's the most unique stringed instrument to come along since the invention of the guitar 300 years ago.
Well, it is pretty neat. Now, how is it different from a standard guitar, other than the fact that it's electric and it doesn't have a resonating chamber?
The guitar, one hand is anchored to the other. You make chords, you strum the strings. This is closer related to a piano. You have independent bass lines and melody lines going on. It's all tapped, so it's hammering.
Now, do people get confused when you tell them you play the Chapman Stick? Do they think they hear something else?
Oh, yes. Oh, I've had varying degrees of astounding confusion. But I think that it's starting to, it's been around now for almost 40 years. I think that it's starting to make its way into bands like, you know, Weather Report, Peter Gabriel, of course, Bruce Coburn.
Yeah. And you have played with big shots, right? Like, including Bruce Coburn.
Yeah, that was wonderful. He's such a remarkable musician, and it was a thrill.
All right, well, we're gonna find out about the Chapman Stick. We're going to see you perform. All right, so back with Dale Ladouceur, and once again, we have the Chapman Stick here. And just before you start to demonstrate this, you've toured extensively. Mm-hmm. You worked in a New York City show. The music was
Black
done
Rider.
By
Tom
Waits.
Tom Waits, William S. Burroughs, yeah.
Tell
that
me
was exciting.
about your work across this planet of ours.
I usually don't do a lot of theater gigs because of the amount of time that they demand, but the Black Rider is definitely something that I never ever miss doing, and we're doing it one last time in Vancouver, January 12th to February 10th.
That's pretty neat.
Yeah, right? It's exciting.
Do you actually get to work with Tom Waits at all during the course of this?
Not this run.
No. But previously.
He has given us his approval. He's seen the show, and he loves it. He thinks that we're fabulous. So it's very special.
Well, excellent. All right. Well, let's find out about this Chapman world. Mm-hmm. First of all, play something that would sound very familiar to us guitar-like,
okay.
And then something that's a little bit more out there, as they say.
You recognize that? That's the Fergus Marsh played with Bruce Coburn. There's Chapman Stick all over that. So it was, it's incredible. But you can do giant. That's giant chords. It's basically five melody strings and five bass strings.
Wow.
It's a stereo head going into two mono. So it's not true stereo, but it's you can process the two sides differently. You can put a delay. Once you get your brain around it, you can get a bass line and then a rhythm. And then...
So someone listening on a record would think that there were two musicians playing.
Yeah.
So are you putting a lot of... bass players onto the street? I mean, are they losing their jobs now?
Well, actually, I think bass and horn players, bass and guitar players, bass and keyboard. And no, I hope not. I hope not. But you usually fall into the realm of a couple of roles, and if you sing, then it's a multitasking for sure.
Well, it's holiday time. I'd like to hear what a Christmas carol might sound like on the Chapman Stick. Can you do something like that?
I would love to hear what a Christmas carol would sound like.
Oh, man, you mean you're gonna leave me hanging right here on national television? You're part of the Christmas Carol project, aren't you?
That is actually an original interpretation of the Dickens classic.
Right, of course.
And
okay.
So you're
not playing
old-fashioned
ones.
No, we've actually, we're telling the story interpretively through song, and we are each character. I'm the Ghost of Christmas Future.
Well, give us a little taste of that future sound.
Oh, the future sound, well, no. I'll give you Alice, which was Scrooge's old girlfriend.
Sounds good.
It's like... A promise is an old one, a promise made when we were young. It's a very baroquey kind of a piece.
Very nice. Let's hear something spooky with all those bass sounds.
With the phaser pedal.
That's very nice. So now, how difficult is it to learn to play this instrument? Do you already have to have mastered the guitar or the bass to play this?
Well, I'm sure that would have helped. I was a hideous guitar player before I picked this up. I immediately clicked with it visually when there was a documentary on the making of Peter Gabriel's Security album.
Right.
And I think it would help if you were a drummer or a keyboard player.
Right. Well, it's very reminiscent of an instrument played in an episode of Star Trek called The Way to Eden. So really, Star Trek hippie music, I love it. Okay, so first, though, we're going to get to a performance by you shortly.
La-la-la, the sun is away. Plans that I've made, running over all the groundwork I've laid. Never ever know what is fleeting and what will stay. And it's out of my hands anyway, out of my mind after today, out of my thoughts and into the grave. La la la, the sun is away. Adore ya, undo every button, solve every rhyme. If you would just let me spend some of your time on me, on me. Leaning close enough to hear every whisper, I want you to wonder. Reaching close enough to get a taste. Take me your secret space, then let's greet the day together. Tell me a tale, show me a sign, part the clouds get out of my mind. Burn a bush or pull out all the hairs, split of the time. You look like a god, you're thinking like Pan, a child, an actor, a god, and a man. I promise to leave you just as I am, to love you. Ah, to love you. Listen closely as I won't be repeating. Look alive as your heart keeps on beating. Go to sleep with nothing to explain, and then rise with the sun again. La la la, the sun is away. La la la, to the start of a brand new day. Away, you take my breath away, you take my breath away.
This is called a jaw harp, or some people call it a Jew's harp.
Banana.
Around alternative instruments, a remarkable world, and before the break we had Tippy Ogogo playing, and he wanted me to let you know that he was playing an Ethiopian song. And right now we're back with the Dale Ladouceur. You got a brand new EP.
CD-EP.
CD coming out, all these letters. So we're coming out, that's called Rough Tracks, and
that's right.
When will it be out?
It'll be out for the opening of the Carol Project at the Roxy on the 14th.
Excellent, so folks can check that out right away. Tell me about the song that you're going to
play. It's called Mercy Mercy, and it was inspired by when Pierre Pettigrew referred to Canada as a product.
Okay, take it away, Dale Ladouceur.
You seem thirsty. Shall I bring you an ocean? You sound tired. Here I'll make room in my coffin. I am so willing and able to lead you through every angle. All of the double breasts bursting, every double chin waggling, and yeah. You seem angry. Shall I get in your way? You sound so lonely. Why won't you just let me stay? I'll just pick up your laundry and then I'll be on my way. Gotta be something in your tone that won't let me leave you alone. Mercy, 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 you're giving it all away. You are so hungry. Shall I fetch you my leg? So cheap, so tender. Don't make me beg, and just raise a glass and glue a smile and sit and chat with me a while. Oh, rise for the shatter, shake. Only everything is at stake. Mercy, mercy. Mercy, mercy. Mercy, mercy, you're giving it all away, giving it all away. Shall I give me away to you? Shall I give you the punchline? Shall I give you the reason to never make up your mind to treat me right? Left, right, left, right, left, out right in the night. Never a seat at the table. The folly of following fable. Mercy, 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 you're giving it all away.
Thank you, Dale. Beautiful. We were just, actually, I'm not going to say that. I'm just going to go right to John right now. We're going to talk about the theremin. Why don't you give me a little bit of the history of the theremin?
Sure. Well, the theremin was invented in about 1919.
Thank you, Dale. Beautiful. We were just, actually, I'm not going to say that. I'm just going to go right to John right now. We're going to talk about the theremin. Why don't you give me a little bit of the history of the theremin?
Sure. Well, the theremin was invented in about 1919.
Welcome back to Help TV. Today, the remarkable world of alternative instruments, and I'm grateful to be joined by Dale Ladouceur on the Chapman Stick. We have Tippy Ogogo on the things, that's right. John Armstong on the theremin. And now, have you all performed as a group together?
We actually did the Millennium Crew project. He was the brainchild behind the Millennium Crew project. So we were at Winston Churchill Square during the turn of the new century. So
tell me what that was. What did your performance consist of?
Eddie Patterson on guitar, and of course Trippy Ogogo and
monkey ears. I got in trouble from the mayor.
No, it was
ear.
I think so. Yeah, I wouldn't. It was beautiful, and I was on Stick. It was Kalipakula on drums.
No.
Kim Glanville on drums, yeah. And it was. We did a CD, and it was incredible. It was all Alberta stuff. So many artists.
Yeah. Now let me ask you each what it is that you most appreciate about each other's playing. Because you're working together, you're obviously getting some value from each person contributing to the trio. So, John, could I start with you? What do you most like about what each of these musicians can do?
Well, they're both so beautiful, and they're both so talented. They both do so much. You know, like, I love playing with Tip because he covers all the bases. And, you know, it's great watching Dale perform, and amazing to see her playing both parts on the Stick and singing so beautifully as well. And they're both great writers, so what's not to like?
Yes, and of course, Dale, you write articles as well. You write political articles and so forth. Now, what about you? What do you most appreciate about working with both of these gentlemen?
Well, aside from the fact that they have beautiful, beautiful dispositions, there is John is constantly ideas man. He plays amazing bass as well, which I don't think he has been able to rig up with his theremin usage, but I'm hoping to. And Tippy, a pure original talent.
Mm-hmm. And how about you, Tippy? What do you like about working with these?
Well, Dale's been the sexiest Chapman Stick player since Daniel from San Francisco. What was that Daniel's name?
Daniel Kane.
Daniel Kane. He's pretty sexy. Black guy there. And then, of course, John was never as sexy as Dale, but he's got sexy chops. So.
That loungy stance.
In fact, it says that on your website, as I recall, that you have sexy chops. All right. So I was fascinated while you were playing because you did also some kind of a voice modulation there. Can you tell me about that?
But this unit down here, Voice Live, it's called, by TC Helicon, and it's got everything in there. It's got pitch correction and multi-harmonies and reverbs and delays and octavers and pitch shifters, you name it.
So I would like to host this show permanently with my voice modulated like yours. How much would this unit cost me?
Yeah, about $1,000.
$1,000?
You'd have a lot of fun with it.
And the theremin you said was about $650.
Yeah, I believe so.
And over here we've got
another $1,300, $1,400 worth of it.
And Tippy, how much do all of your materials cost?
Well, the drum, like the principal drum is a snare drum tuned down. That was $5. The cans are free. Snare drum I got for $20. I got the crash cymbal in grade 10, and it, at the time was $50. The thing that costs the units are, this unit's maybe about $700, and this thing's about $400, and the board's about $200. So.
Okay, so
yes,
you're trying to be all Mr. Yeah. Inexpensive, yeah. But really, you got some expensive gear
free,
there. All right.
When you drink them.
All right. Okay. Well, so amazing stuff here. Thank you all of you for being with us today. This has been extremely exciting. And what's the name of this song that you're about to perform?
It's called Nobody.
Nobody. All right. Well, let's hear it. Take it away, then.
All right.
Who amongst us deserves to be homeless? Is there anybody out there who really deserves to be hungry or cold? Which one of you should have to wait longer for healthcare? And who should decide when your rights may be sold? Nobody, nobody, no, no, nobody, nobody. Is there anybody out there that would destroy a species of animal? Does anyone actually want to pollute our world? Which one of you will step up and drink the water when it's no longer clean and it's no longer pure? No. Thank you. songstress believes that violence is a viable solution. Which of you really wants to go to war? Who amongst you are gonna send your children? And tell me, does anybody really know what we're fighting for? Gonna keep us all quiet? And who precisely is gonna keep us all down? Who is gonna profit from their greed and deception when we commit to sharing what's going around? Bye.